So it's just a nice way to make me feel comfortable and stuff.
Yes.
We tried it. 19 minutes later.
Thank you. This is so easy. I'm Wendy. I'm not a programmer, and I do mostly marketing of Perl because I can do that and I'm not very good at programming. So I do marketing, simple. But marketing of Perl is, I think, easy because I think Perl is awesome. I even think that Perl 6 is awesome. That's why I'm wearing this T-shirt. By the way, if you have a question or want to discuss something, you're very much welcome to interrupt me. Research at marketing is something that we hear a lot. Okay. Oh, come on, that's so old. We are really good at marketing because when we do it quite well. Mostly it is true. Perl is still not overly visible, it's not flashy, it's not that people think that line noise, blah. And Perl people mostly want just want to program. They want to upload stuff, they want to hack at hackathons and hack at other places and hack in their bedroom. And they are proud of their work. Some of those people publish about it, but only some. I think publishing is this and more. Most people don't publish. I go to Perl events all the time, and when I talk to them about their work, that's what Perl is for them. Work. It's nothing special, just what they do. It's so normal. Being in a herd, go to work, go home again. So why all the fuss? Why publish something about something normal? Everybody does work, and it's difficult, and they have all those other excuses like and that's more excuses that they have. And that last line, my work is not that interesting. For me, whenever I talk to Perl people, I found something interesting in their work all the time. A couple of weeks ago, Damien Conway was in the Netherlands, and at the party afterwards, I spoke to several people. And one group of them were from a big supermarket in the Netherlands. And I was so happy that they told me that, because I want to use that information. It turns out that every cash register of that supermarket is in fact a Linux machine with Perl. And all the programs running on that thing are Perl. And so somebody takes an article, does beep beep, Perl handles that.
What's the name?
No, there's a camera there. So they told me not to say that when the camera's running.
Okay.
I can tell you later. So it was the cache says that does beep beep and signal is going back to the server that does their stock management. So they just know when they're running out of beer, of that type of beer, or this type of sugar, or whatever. Or the cherries are gone. Have another cherry. Yeah, that one. And then I invited them to get a talk here because, oh man, that would be smashing. Like, this would be news. It would be a buzz in the Perl community. I think that supermarket is doing Perl. I think it's same level of importance that Booking is using Perl. And still, many people are surprised. What? Booking? Perl? Really? That's marketing. Marketing is that you talk about some aspects of your work, so other people will know that you use Perl in your work. Anyway, right, no, wrong. When we all think that way, nobody learns about our Perl projects, about all the interesting stuff that is done. Like the supermarket, like the VID, that's a Dutch traffic information service. I can say that because they've given a talk about that. So when you drive on the Dutch highway, every now and then you see this little pole next to the highway with solar cells on top. And on the bottom half of the pole there's this little box. And inside the box is a print plate with chips and whatever. And that thing is programmed with Perl. It tries to capture your Bluetooth MAC address. And a bit down the road there's another tall like this, that also capturing your mech address. So that thing knows the distance from the previous pole, and it also knows the time that you were there and that you're here, so it calculates the distance, the speed of the traffic. Yeah. So if it goes below 80, very soon all the portals over the highway say 80. Careful, drive 80. If it's 60, it turns to 50, because 60 means this close to a traffic jam. And if they go off, it means it has seen that everybody's driving 120 again. And that's done with Perl. All of that stuff is done with Perl. That was quite a surprise for us to hear that last year at Vosdam. They gave a talk, no, was that Dutch Perl workshop 2 years ago?
That was
it. Stuff like that. Everybody at their work does something that is special like this. And when people talk about that, I think that's marketing for Perl, making Perl more well known. And I think that's a way to tell other people, if you use Perl, you will have an interesting job. Okay, that's the two things I just mentioned. So please publish. Some examples of Perl people that publish. So somebody here of this. Jonathan, yes.
What do I publish?
Every now and then. Oh yeah, fine, I will be good. So we know Perl got the job done. Some fields that we know that Perl is used in extensively. Yeah. Another thing that I think shows nicely the force, the importance of Perl is a growing list of companies that use Perl. Vicky Brasseur started some time ago collecting data from jobs.perl.org. That's public information, but you can collect it, make a list of companies that use Perl. I think it's quite an impressive list of names, which is just 4 pages. Oh wait, it's 8. Oh wait, it's a lot. This is just a section of it. It's a really, really long list of company names that use Perl, and that they let other people know that they use Perl, but they don't tell them what they do. If just 1% of these companies would publish what they do with Perl, the magazine would be filled with Perl again. People would start writing Perl books again. At the last years, we are down to 3 to 5 books a year. Another language as well. A lot of pulp, of course, but anyway.
Pulp. But we don't need pulp. Thing that not 1% of the companies using Java would be doing that, because then we would be drowned.
Yes, thank you very much for giving me nightmares. Okay. And so, Vicky Brasseur, thank you very much. That's just one way to show the awesomeness. And you can help. So if your company is not on that list, make sure that it will be included there. I was too quick. If you know of other ways to tell people how awesome Perl is, let us know. If you have now an idea like Wendy, do you know about this? Thank you very much. I might use that in my future attempts to market Perl. Some other things that we all know that show that Perl is reasonably awesome. CPAN releases per year. It really shows that Perl is dead, isn't it? yeah. Oh wait, now it's gone.
2014.
Oh. It's a snapshot of the year. It's the absolute numbers. It's not percentage. CPAN authors, awesome group of people. So you've got. They make one release. Those people have 2 to 9 releases. These people, 36% of the CPAN authors, have 10 to 99 releases. And I think this 7% of CPAN authors have more than 100 releases. And 0.2 has even more than 1,000 releases. I think that's awesome. Some other things awesome. Well, you see, booking.com is in there. I like booking.com. Many people don't know that, but BBC is also a very big Perl house. A lot of the special programs that they make, they use Perl for that. What do I do? I don't blog, I don't code, I don't have projects, I don't have modules. I do some marketing by me being there, And by being there year after year, people get used to you. Oh, that's that pro person again. Like I'm being year after year at Vosden. And some other people do that as well. And then we will have a positive effect. Like this year, nobody told me, Pearl, but Pearl is dead, isn't it? Nobody told me that this year at Vosden. I think that's a win. So call me positive, but yeah, that's what I mean. By being there, you're visible, accessible, and you give and get attention. When you do more than just be there, when you talk, write, present, ask, answer, buy, give, influence, help, invent, you also help to market stuff. And some of this is so easy to do. Just think about what you could do. So you're online somewhere and somebody asked this silly question, you can answer that. If you don't do it, you just hope that somebody else does. But no, if nobody else does, and you don't it, nobody answers that. That's a failed marketing attempt. Okay, did that answer? That's what I say, quite often. And then after that, I give them some examples of how alive Pearl is. This is what I do. I share it. I don't Twitter, but I do Facebook, and I send it to my local Pearl monolith. Some other people do Twitter, quite a lot. I know several people that try to get their presentation on that event, if it's at least a little bit applicable. And some people try to convince colleagues and fellow Pearl members to give a presentation there as well. If you see or hear somebody say something negative about Pearl in a magazine or a blog or a mailing list, please reply in a positive way. Don't start yelling, screaming, cursing. Be polite, be positive, but answer. Like if somebody says, Pearl is in decline, just answer that, because that measuring tool is not correct sometimes. Well, several people here go to and or organize things. I co-organized last year's presence there. I helped the people there. I organized that for years, our presence there. I've helped at hackathons. I've been at EU and North America. Yapsis, I've been at way too much workshops by now. And I'm a member of way too many Perlmonger groups to be healthy for me, I think. I wear a Pearl t-shirt. I wear a Pearl button. Well, this is not a sticker, but I wear it. And it's Pearl. So that's what I do. And I call my style guerrilla marketing. And that link tells you all about guerrilla marketing. It's the cheapest way of marketing. It just costs you a bit of time. And since you're spending time on Pearl anyway, why don't you check it out? I don't have money for this. And I think this is not productive for something like Pearl. I do a bit of sponsoring. No, I'm running out of time. Okay, I do a bit of sponsoring. I'm going to events, and that shows other people that they're not alone. Really, they're not alone. They're together. Other ways to convince people. I told about that. Yeah, talk about that. So I love books. I buy books, Pearl books, lots of Pearl books. And people ask me, are they for sale? Nope, I collect them. And I start thinking, but hey, maybe I should. So I asked O'Reilly, they gave me a good deal. And Odex Neon gave me a good deal, Rox gave me a good deal, Mostarx and Sam's gave me a good deal. So now I can offer you books for a very low price. Books, I love books. Gabo Sabo was the first one introducing me to Twits. So, I'm Twits made. This is the big, largest Twit in the world. It's 4 meter 40 high. I've had a Twit here. I so felt like Scrooge McDuck. So, I bought Twits, and I bought Twits. I gave all of these away. There's only something like 20 left. These are the types of Twits that I made. So far, I still need to make Twits for 2014. The year is almost half over, but... So, I'm sure that I will get around to it. I have a friend who makes buttons for me. And when you wear a button, it shows commitment. Buttons! And I have stickers. Stickers. Camels from Dubai. Theo told me about that. So, I've got lovely camels, lots of camels. Camels for Pearl 5 and for Pearl 6. Mugs of Pearl, yes. Well, at some point Liz told me, our collection of kill books is too heavy. Okay, make a model banners, that's easier. I made some brochures. I plan to make more brochures. Hang on. Yeah? Okay. When I'm in an event and I see some people having Pearl stuff, I ask, do you want to carry it home? And they say no, and then they give it to me and I carry it home and give it away at the next event. Otherwise, they might throw it away. I think that's a waste of Pearl stuff. I often ask for a table when I'm somewhere and I cover that with my stuff. So please join me. Ask me for buttons, tools, stickers to give away to other people. Not just for yourself, but for colleagues and friends and family and little children. They love camels. So it means love for Pearl. So please spread the love. Love Pearl. Thank you all. And what you see there in our hands is the trophy that we won last year. The white camel award. So proud of that. Thank you very much. That's it. What a time now, I guess. No time for questions. Any questions? No?
Thank you.